Hallo, Connie hier, Sibi's Kleuren en zo. In the stream last night I started this picture in this beautiful Flora and Fauna book from Colorin Haven. This is the special by Kelly O'Gorman, and it's a lovely book. And I started with this letter M, and I'm coloring with the Derwent Artist, and I want to do something more today, so let's get started. And I want to start with a marigold here in the bottom corner. I think it is a little sunny on sunshine on the page. I think the marigold are called Afrikaantjes in Dutch. And most of the time they are dark yellow, orange, different colors in that color scheme. So I want to color them orange. Zoom you in a little. And maybe a little more. My camera won't zoom anymore, so I have to do it like this. And I hope I have room enough for my pencils. Is it sharp? I have to check. Yeah, I think so. It's clear now. I have picked three colors. And it's the Scarlet Lake. 1200. The Spectrum Orange. I think Spectrum Orange. It's 1100 and the Deep Chrome 0900. I start with a light one. I want to color all the leaves. And with the Derwent Artist is a harder pencil, and you have to color layers. That's working the best with these pencils. I'm not pressing hard, I'm going very, maybe the sound is hard, but I'm having a very light pressure on the pencil. I think it's because there's a little foot on the paper that you hear the kind of scrubbing on the pencil. I'm coloring very light. I colored a whole flower with this light color. And then I'm going to build it up. So a nice basic layer. Something to work on. Here's a little bud. Difficult coloring with my camera so low on the page. It's in front of my nose. I think this is a nice layer to start with. Now I go to the dark one, that is the Scarlet Lake, and I want the middle a bit darker, the middle of the petals. I think they are called petals, the leaves of the flower. I hope I'm not shaking my kettles. I want it a little more dark. I try this one. It's too red. It's the bright red, so. No, I think it's okay. It's not that red. Those colors aren't so vibrant like the polychromos or the prismacolors. When you build them up, you can get a nice result. I hope so too. It's gonna be nice. It's really difficult to get it done. It's my camera so low. It used to zoom in a little more when it was new, but I don't do it anymore. I'm looking for my rust, is this one. Rust. It's a little bunker. It's not really bright. It's a mineral. Back in with the spectrum orange. Maybe it's too dark. This is the deep brown. Yeah, I think that's better. I call them all for everything, including the dark parts, to brighten them up a little. I want it to be a nice sunny flower. Brighten up the page. You must be patient with these pencils because you have to color a lot of layers to get the color down. I think it's much easier with Prismacolors or the Polycolors. No, not the polycolors, the polychromos. Because they are much softer. And I think they are brighter. I've chosen this and I keep going. That will be okay. And just take a little bit more time. So that these orange ones are more difficult than the pink ones I used for the magnolia. It's much easier to get a cover down the pink ones. I sharpen my pencil a little. Spaces here. I'm still layering my colors. Be a little boring to watch. I'm sorry. This is the geranium lake. It's a little more red in it. Want to darken those little parts a little so that it has a little more contrast. There are not 20 of this marigold flowers in the picture. It would take me a whole week to color. But I'm getting there. They are already looking nice and bright. Let's go a little outside the line of here. Oh. want on an orange one. Orange grown. Going to do a last layer over everything. Kind of blending it up. With a little darker orange. Giving it a little more shine. Let's put it over here. Nice and bright. Like so. I want it to really dark in the middle. Like this one. Maybe I use some discards or some oops, sorry about that. It was too sharp. So, now we have to color the leaves of the flowers. I think they are a nice dark green. This is the cedar, maybe that's too blue. Let me have a look. Here is the sap green, I think I like that one. Because there are a lot of leaves, I don't want to use the same greens everywhere. Or changing between the green ones. Some a little more yellow, some a little more blue. Darker, a little lighter. want a little lighter green. I think I use this one. It's almost green. This one. This is the May green. Some of those things in this picture are tiny, so it's a bit harder to stay between the lines. And this bud over here. Taking another green. I like to mix my greens. So I think the marigold is finished. Maybe we can do something on the berries of the. I have to zoom out a little because I can hardly see what I'm doing. These are a kind of white, so I think they are difficult to color. I think I can use some grays, maybe a very light green. Looking for a grey one. I'm not used to the colours because I don't use them so often. Silver grey. Where is it? Elf grey, six, yeah. Fell mist. Here's my silver grey. Maybe a little darker one. And you use your pencils a little more often, you are more used to the colors. That makes it easier. So I have to use them a little more. It's a nice lesson. This is a gunmetal. It's a little darker gray. I'm using it for the shadows in the berries. And they are a kind of, yeah, almost like they are from milk glass. And you see them in the middle of your life. But I don't think I can get that effect. I'm coloring them. I'll try. And they are my berries, so I can make them like I want to. But I want to make them nice, so. This one, this is parchment 5 and 5 0. I think this is working. A combination of those two colors. They must look around. This one is in the shadow, so it can be a little darker. I'm blending this with the gray. I think they look nice. I don't know if you can see it on the camera because it's a very light color, but that's what I wanted. I have to do something more on the leaves. And this is the olive green. Oh, my voice. I have to take a little drink. Sorry about that, so that's better. Now a lighter color, the chartreuse is a nice one. I mistletoe done. We have done marigolds and mistletoe. I finished the magnolia last night and the monkey. So I have to work on the morning glory, but I can do that off stream. And I think I'll show it to you when it's finished. Thank you for watching.